Hello and welcome to our third class on mathematical typing. In this class, we are going to learn a few shortcuts and how to use these shortcuts so that you can easily write your equations and reduce your time while writing the equations instead of again and again going to the equation tab. So I have made a few lists over here. You can see subscript, superscript, fractions, the different kinds of arrows. Then you have plus minus signs, minus plus signs. You have greater than equal to, less than equal to, not equal to. You have equivalent sign, proportional sign, sum, infinity, therefore, since, for all, subset, integral, and then you have x bar, x vector, you have square root, all these things, and then you have a few Greek letters as well. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to take basic shortcuts in this class and I'm just going to deal with the basic ones. So I'll just click on alt equal to will give me this equation over here wherein I can type all my equations, right? So let me just move ahead and start with the very basic one. So the very basic one is x square. How do you write it? X, and then what do you need to do is you need to use this caret symbol which is there on the, you use this by writing by clicking on shift 6 caret, and then x, you just simply write a 2 and give a space. So the moment you click on the space, you get x square, right? If you need x and in the subscript you need 2, so what do you need to do? X, use a underscore 2, and then again click on the space. Do not ever forget to click on the space, because the moment you click on the space, the formula gets added. So now it's x and in the subscript you have a 2. Similarly, suppose you want x by 2. How to do that? X, simply give a forward slash. So this is the forward slash x by 2, and click on the space again and it gives you x by 2. Okay, now we are going to see how to use different arrows, how to get different arrows. Now how to get different arrows, you just need to write this backward slash. This backward slash is present on top of your enter key, and then you just need to write left arrow and click on the space, and see, it gives you the left arrow. Similarly, it will give you the right arrow if you just write right arrow, and you just need to click on the space, it gives you right arrow. To get the right arrow, the easier way is to write a minus. This is minus and greater than sign. So this gives you right arrow, minus, greater than sign. You don't have to even click on the space and you get the right arrow. Similarly, if you want to get down arrow, so you have down, you just need to write down arrow and space, you get the down arrow. For the up arrow, you write up arrow and you get the up arrow. Similarly, suppose you want southeast facing arrow, so you just need to write SE, southeast arrow, space, and it gives you southeast arrow. Similarly, you have northeast, NE, so I'll just write NE and arrow and space, and you get the northeast. Similarly, you have southwest, northwest. So you can see that I'm not going to do. It's very simple. You just need to write NW arrow and you get the northwest and SW for southwest arrow. The next thing is, suppose you want both left-right arrow. Maybe you want to show it for an equivalence. So what you can do is you can just write left-right arrow and space, and it gives you left-right arrow. Then we have, if you write capital L left arrow and you click on the space, what you will get is the double left arrow. So this is the double left arrow which we get. Similarly, if you write capital R arrow, you get a double right arrow. Basically, this is used for implies to. Okay, then we have, similarly, if you write capital D down arrow, you'll get double down arrow. Similarly, you have it for up arrow, and see, this is the up arrow which you get. All these were the different types of arrows. Now what we can do is, again, let me just get into the equation over here. The different sets of equation which the different sets of the shortcuts which we can use is, we can use the times. So suppose you want to write 2 into 3. So you do not use the star mark which you have. This is the star which you have, or the X. You do not use this in the equation, because then it looks very odd. So you need to use this cross which you get using slash, backward slash, times. So you get the times sign. You do not use the star or you do not use the x, because then it looks weird within an equation. Now you need a plus minus sign, so you can just simply write PM and you get the plus minus sign. To get the minus plus sign, you just need to write MP and you get the minus plus sign. So this is minus plus sign. Again, if you want to get minus plus sign or plus minus sign, the easier way is to just is to write plus and then a minus. So see, you do not have to use the backward arrow, or neither do not, you do not have to use the space. Similarly, minus plus, and you get the minus plus as well. You do not have to use the backward slash, neither you have to use the space. The next thing, if you want to use, when want to get greater than equal to or less than equal to, simply you just need to write greater than equal to and you get the greater than equal to, less than equal to and you get the less than equal to. So you just need to click like greater than equal to and it just adds over there. So it's very simple. The next set of equations, suppose if you want not equal to, so you write NE backward slash NE, you get a not equal to sign. Similarly, if you want equivalent sign, so you just need to write EQUIV and it gives you equivalent sign over here. Then you have approximate sign or similar sign, which you need to write SIM and you get this similar sign over here. Similarly equal to SIMEQ and it gives you similarly equal to, exactly similar. And then you have a congruent sign. For congruent sign, you just need to write CONG and you just need to click on the space and you get the congruent sign. Next we have approximate sign, so you just need to write approx and click on the space and you get the approximate sign as well. Infinity sign, INFY, so it's TY and you get the infinity sign. Then you have proportional to sign, so PROPT proportional to sign and you get the PROPTO, so you get the proportional to sign. All the formulas, all the shortcuts have been written, so you do not have to copy it down. You can just use this PDF which I'll attach to my video. The next thing is the sum, so I'll just create a new equation over here. New equation tab, alt equal to, and then suppose I need the summation sign, which is used many a times. So you just need to write backward slash sum space and it gives you the summation sign. Okay, so this was your summation sign. The next is, so let me just get it back, sum, and it gives you the summation sign. The next we can use is your therefore and since, because these are also used a lot by us. So to get that, we'll write therefore, the entire thing, and then you get the therefore sign. Similarly, for getting the since sign, you just need to write because and you get the since. If you want for all, so you just need to write for all, do not give any space in between, click on the space button then and you get the for all sign. If you need to get subset, so you need to write subset space and it gives you the subset. If you want in sign, basically, so what do you need to do is write in, basically belongs to sign. If you want belongs to sign, this gives you the belongs to sign. Then you want to get integral, you just need to write int, which is followed by a, so int, and it gives you the integral sign. The next set of shortcuts which we'll see is very simple, is the over bar shortcut. So wait, what is an over bar shortcut? Just let me give you a hint first. I'll just write over bar and see, it gives you the over bar over here. Now what exactly is over bar? The moment you click on the space, you get this box. You can go to this box and you can just write whatever you want to. So let me just give you one more hint over here. Instead of this, what you could have done, suppose I want A plus B and the entire thing should be with a bar on top of it. So how to get that? We'll just use the backward slash, and then what we can do is I'll just write over bar over here space, and then within the brackets I'll write a plus b space, and see, it adds the over bar to the whole of it. Again, I will show you all how to do this. Over bar, I'll click on a space, it gives me the bar, open the bracket, a plus b, close the bracket and a space, and it adds in the whole. Or what you could have done is you could have written over bar space space, and see, you get this box, then click on the left arrow once. So if you click on the left arrow once, you get within the bar, and then you can type a plus b. So it's exactly similar. To get out of it, you just need to click on the right arrow twice and you just move out of it. So this was the over bar. Moving on to the next, we can have now x bar. Let me just see how you can write x bar in a easier way. You can do x, then you can use this backward slash and write a bar space, it will give you x bar. Just press space twice. If you need x double bar, how to get that? X and this backward slash and use a capital B and click on the space twice, and see, you get x double bar. Similarly, if you want x vector, so x and a backward slash b e c, and you just need to click on the space twice and you get the x vector as well. Similarly, if you want a by b, then you can write a, and there is something as atop. So backward slash atop space and then a b and again a space, and see, you get the a by b over here, right? The next thing we are going to see are the Greek alphabets. So the Greek alphabets are very simple. You just need to type in the letters you want to, and you just get the alphabets exactly in the same way. You need to use the backward slash again, half alpha, click on the space and you get the alpha. Similarly, you write beta, click on the space and you get beta. Similarly, write gamma, you get gamma. Then if you want maybe theta, just you need to write theta and space. Delta is also there, so delta is there. Then if you want sigma, so sigma is also there. These are a few Greek letters which we use, though especially sigma we use, alpha we use, beta. These are some symbols which we use almost every time. Then we have something which is used very less, maybe omega, and we have also a capital omega. So you just need to write capital O with that and you get this. We also have iota, which is not so much in use. So what do you need to do is you just need to write, you get an iota over here, and then you have something as epsilon. Epsilon is generally used by us in CS2 maybe, and then we have phi. Phi is also there. We have mu, so for that you just need to write mu mu and you get the mu symbol. Also, there are some more mathematical equations which you can get. So suppose I want square root, so for that again I'll use the forward slash and I'll write square root, and you get the square root. And see, if you click on the space twice, it gives a box over here. Again, you just need to click on the left arrow to move within the box, and here you can type whatever you want to. The next thing is, suppose you want a by b, so how to do that? A, use a forward slash and then b. So a forward slash b will give you a by b. So this is how interesting your various different shortcuts are. It's very simple to use. You just need to use backward slash for most of the things, and you need to type it down whatever you want. Most of it are common, so you'll just memorize it if you use it even once. Also, there are some more shortcuts which we'll learn through when we type the equations. These were the basic ones which I gave you all separately. Now what we are going to do, we are going to write our equations as we did in our previous class, and those equations we'll write using the shortcuts. We are not going to use these structures, but we are going to use the shortcuts for this. So that is for this class, and for next class we are going to write the equations which we did in the last class using the shortcuts. Thank you.